Welcome back to my Halloween Horror Reviews 2022. I hope y'all are enjoying the reviews so far, but like the Carpenter said in 1408... There is so much more goodness coming this month, including with, well, if you want to talk about goodness with this movie, that is if you can call this movie good. Remember how I mentioned in my review of Aliens how we were moving from shit and ascending to the heavens with aliens? Well guys, I'm sad to say that with today's review, we're going back right down to shit. If you have heard of this movie, I will be actually very surprised, but with that being said guys, moving on to today's review, we're going to be talking about 2005's Boogeyman, directed by Stephen Kay. Like I just said, if you guys actually know about this movie, I will be very, very surprised. Boogeyman is basically a take on the classic monster, you know, the Boogeyman, the monster that lives either in your closet or the monster that lives underneath your bed. In Boogeyman, we follow a character named Tim who is portrayed by Barry Watson. As a kid, Tim witnesses his father being taken actually by the Boogeyman. Tim has a phobia of closets and mattresses that basically have a dark side underneath. He has a girlfriend that has no idea of this phobia or even that his father was taken by a boogeyman. Tim's mother has unfortunately passed away as of recently, and he gets the advice to go back home, spend one night in that home that his father was taken away from to confront his fears to hopefully get better. Alrighty guys, so let's get into Boogeyman.
Damien!
I don't really have positives for Boogeyman, as I call the more redemptive qualities for Boogeyman. And there's only one thing I can think of when it comes to this movie. The opening 5 minutes of Boogeyman are actually, they're not bad. They really are not that bad. In fact, they're kind of decent. It does actually a really cool job of setting up what Tim is afraid of and building up this creature that Tim is afraid of going into his adult years. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, after the opening 5 minutes, I was just going like, whoa, okay, let's see where this goes. Yeah. All right, moving on.
Happy Purge, you old fuck.
Before I continue, I want to talk about this movie. Of course, it is story time. I was about 12 years old when Boogeyman came out. I wasn't quite 13 yet, but this movie came out in theaters. Did not see it. I didn't even think I remember seeing a trailer of this movie in the theaters, let alone on moviephone.com. Yeah, remember moviephone.com those days? This was probably 5 months after it came out in theaters. I remember that on moviephone.com, it was promoting the DVD for Boogeyman, and I saw the trailer and I was just going like, oh my god, I just see this right now. When you see that DVD cover, it looked cool as hell when I was a little kid, so of course I was interested in seeing it.
You serious?
And it came to Blockbuster that weekend. My dad took my brother and I to go to Blockbuster that weekend. I remember renting that movie, and of course, I've mentioned this plenty of times on my channel. Besides my mother and I, who love horror films, my dad and my brother only watch select horror films out there. Like, for example, my dad loves The Shining, he loves The Exorcist, but typically, my brother and my dad stay far, I mean, far away from horror films. I was up late, I popped in the DVD, and if I remember correctly, even before I was a teenager and I watched this movie, the movie I thought was cool-ish, but nothing about Boogeyman actually particularly scared me. It's 2022. I have not seen this movie since then, and of course, I had the idea to review this movie for this month's Halloween Horror Reviews, because I was thinking, you know what? Let's see if this movie holds up over time. Oh my god, guys. This movie is so stupid. The performances of this movie, Barry Watson from IFR has become quite an accomplished actor. He's added in a couple of other things. In this movie, you can tell that Barry Watson is doing everything that he possibly can with the script that he is given. But even then, everything either comes off as melodramatic or just, well, one note. Everybody else in this movie is either one note, dull, or it seems like they are just line reading. Let's talk about the story of Boogeyman. The story of Boogeyman has a lot of potential. Like I mentioned earlier, this is a take on the Boogeyman. You know, the supposed creature that lives either in your closet or right underneath this bed.
And they're not fucking in there, asshole.
If you guys want a great recommendation of a modernization of a boogeyman, The Babadook. This movie is fucking awesome. The opening 5 minutes has set up as to why Tim visualizes and has those fears. Tim seeing these things that showcases why it all manifests into the boogeyman, and it actually shows some pretty cool stuff. Unfortunately though, the movie doesn't do anything with that stuff until literally the final 10 minutes of this movie. They do a story that's been there and done that, and what do I mean exactly? Basically is this. Main character has a phobia. They won't say what their phobia is to other people because they'll think he's fucking crazy. And when he does, they do think he's crazy until, guess what? The final act when they're going like, oh, so he's telling the truth. I know I should say this for later, but you know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna talk about it right now. This was so stupid, but you know what? I have to mention it. So spoiler in case you guys care. I don't think you will. Seriously, are you guys gonna watch this movie? In the third act of this movie, the boogeyman goes after everybody that Tim cares for. In particular, his girlfriend, his uncle, and his childhood friend. It seems like all hope is lost until... oh, God. Tim goes through a closet and literally... he goes back in time to hopefully save the people he cares about. They introduce time travel out of nowhere. I want to talk about the writing, and I bring this up for one particular reason. Boogeyman was written by three people: Eric Kripke, Stiles White, and Juliet Snowden. You may recognize one of those names, Eric Kripke. Why may you recognize Eric Kripke? That is because he developed Supernatural and The Boys. I really think that Eric Kripke wrote the opening 5 minutes, and if it's true, I would not be surprised. Let's talk about the other two writers, Stiles White and Juliet Snowden. If you guys don't know them, you may know a movie that they made a couple of years later, actually almost a decade later. Oh yeah. Those two were involved with that movie. After I saw that, everything made so much sense. Oh my God, is the writing in this movie so bad. And the dialogue? Holy shnikes, is it bad. One thing in particular I want to talk about here is the cinematography. If you've seen a lot of horror films from the 2000s, like mid, like honestly the whole 2000s decade, a lot of horror films, minus a select few, were shot and looked basically like MTV music videos. From the way they move the cameras, the shot style, the framing, the composition. I will give credit where credit is due. Boogeyman definitely has style to it. It definitely does. But all that style doesn't mean jack shit when your movie has slim to no substance. And when I mean slim, I mean probably 0.00001% of substance. There's some cool camera movements, don't get me wrong. But I will say though, in terms of the camera movements, I don't know why they did this, but there's a specific shot in this movie that takes place in the third act. I'll actually show it to you guys right here, where they do this. What was the point of all of that movement? All you needed was that one push in, and that's it. Maybe if you want to be cool, move the camera up a little bit, but you don't need that much in there. Do you just want to be cool and show off your skills? Sure. Holy crap, I just realized it sounds like I hate this movie more than I expected, to which, don't get me wrong, this movie is not good at all. Let's talk about the scares of Boogeyman. What scares? I mean, sure, do not get me wrong. Are there scares in this movie? Sure. But are they scary? No. What this movie will do for a scare is that basically there will be a scene where there will be a bunch of flash cuts with imagery of a boogeyman, and it's accompanied by just a sound, and it's supposed to be scary. It's not scary at all. There's jump scares, but they aren't scary. And some of the scares are even so laughable, including the design. It cracks me just thinking about this. Oh my God. Including the look of the boogeyman itself. Oh my God, does the boogeyman look so bad. It looks like a monster rejected from a PS2 game. And when you see a close-up, it is so goofy looking. Especially when it does this. That scene was so fucking stupid. Oh my god. The final sequence of the Boogeyman. I will say this though. It finally brings up those ideas that were set up in the beginning. But again, the movie doesn't do anything with them. It just goes like, oh, Tim was scared of these things. Let's destroy them and the Boogeyman's gonna go away. It's not brought up at all during the movie. The next thing I'm gonna talk about here, guys, this is gonna absolutely blow your mind, but trust me, this actually happens in the movie. The ending of the movie. More specifically, the post-credits scene. Boogeyman has a post-credits scene that sets up for a sequel. Boogeyman not only got a sequel, but a whole trilogy! So overall, Boogeyman is generic, it's by the numbers, it's been there and done that, but most of all, it is not scary. Now sure, the first 5 minutes have promise, but that promise is soon tanked, and then this movie does a hard nosedive right afterwards. All in all, I'm going to give Boogeyman a 0.5 out of 5 stars. Now sure, the movie isn't a straight up zero, and it does have a redemptive quality to it, but is it a good movie? Hell no. Simply put, guys, stay away from Boogeyman and don't even bother going for the sequels. Seriously, I forgot the sequels existed. So comment down below and let me know. Have you guys seen Boogeyman? Have you even heard the film? Seriously, if you have, I'll be very surprised. But seriously, let me know below. If you guys want to follow me on social media, I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch. I'm also on Snapchat. So if y'all want to follow me on all those social media platforms, all the links in the description below. That's going to wrap it up for my review of Boogeyman. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If so, please hit that like button, also subscribe, and don't forget to hit that notification bell for my latest review of my Halloween Horror Reviews 2022 goes live. If you guys want to see any of my previous 2 reviews, please click it right there or right there. And of course, to do my next review of my Halloween Horror Reviews 2022 goes live, I will see you all next time.